Lightroom is fantastic, but when you throw in the power of the Nik Collection, things get really exciting. I'm going to walk you through a few of the Nik 7 collection to make your landscapes better. And stick around to the end of the video to unlock an exclusive discount code. I have already installed the Nik Collection on my PC. We'll now show you how well it is integrated with Lightroom by demoing this to you. I have this image of rice fields opened in Lightroom. I won't do much here, just increase the exposure a tad bit. To access the Nik Collection, going to the photo menu, edit in. Here we can find all the installed plugins. I'm going to start with Nik 7 Color Efex. Just clicking on it, with the first option selected, as it says the current edits in Lightroom will move over to the Color Efex. Make sure the file format selected is TIFF, as it supports non-destructive editing. Click on Edit. This takes it directly to the Color Efex interface. Make sure to enable non-destructive edits. On the left, you can find the categories sorted alphabetically. Clicking on each one of them gets you dedicated filters related to the category, and also the presets. Clicking on a preset is a nice way to start, especially for beginners. And you can find all the filters with customized tunings associated with this preset on the right. And each filter has their own presets. You can click on Enable the Favorites option for filters. I have already made my favorites here. Just click on the favorites to access these. Also the recently used filters. You can also access the history of the edits done recently. Clicking on original resets all the filters applied. You can make your own categories too by clicking on the three dots and creating a new category. For this image, I'm going to start with this filter, contrast only. By the way, I'm now in landscape category. We'll see the preset which is right for the look I'm going for, or maybe you get an idea if you're a bit confused what you're going for. This is a good starting point. Selecting soft contrast preset, you can see the sliders associated with it already tuned. It looks too contrasty, so I'm going to dial it down a bit. You also have the opacity slider to control the overall intensity of the filter. We'll see if the saturation helps here. Next, one of my favorite filters, foliage. Make sure to click on the plus button or else the previous selected filter will be removed. You can see on the right, this filter getting added to the list. We'll select the more vibrant method here. This already looks good. Controlling the intensity of the foliage here. You can click on the buttons at the top to compare this from the original. Also the split before and after view. You can zoom into and drag the slider to get a good comparison of what the difference is. I am not too happy with the foliage affecting the colors on this particular part. So now I'm going to use the control point by placing it here on the image. You can see the mask by clicking on this square icon. Controlling the mask with luminance slider here. Chrominance to fine-tune the selection. You can see now the overall mask. The foliage filter is not affecting this part of the image. This is already in the Photoshop territory, considering we are still working in a Lightroom plugin. You can control the overall intensity of the control point too. You can also control the mask within the control point interface on the image too. If you want to reset the sliders, you can click on this button to get the reset options. Now I will add the graduated filters. Clicking on the plus button to add to the list of the filters for this image. You can see on the left with the orangish lines to get a visual reference which filters are enabled on this image. This is a cool filter, especially for the images with sky. We'll select this blue option here. You can tune the vertical shift depending on the size of the sky in the image. We'll control the blues here by reducing the opacity. We'll also add glamour glow here, which gives the image a dreamy soft look. You should be familiar with this filter if you're using the Snapseed mobile app. And fun fact, Snapseed was originally created by the Nik team, so some of the filters are common. With all the customization I have done here with different filters involved to make it easy for future edits, I can save this as a separate preset. This saved preset can be found in the custom category for one-click edits. Applying this, we'll get back to you to the Lightroom app with the new look we made from the Color Efex. If you go back to the Color Efex and select Edit Original, the image opens in Color Efex with all the filters we already applied earlier, so that we can continue from the point where we stopped. If you want to switch to a different plugin, you can directly do it from here by clicking Switch to and selecting a different plugin. Here I will select HDR Efex. I'm going to try HDR Efex on this image of Monument Valley. I'm going to select this preset, adding subtle texture. HDR effect could be too much, so trying here to make it more subtle. Bit of saturation and tuning it to make a bit more eye pleasing, but not overbearing. Now moving to the plugin Viveza. Here you can see this has more of basic sliders that you normally see in Lightroom. So without going to Lightroom, you more or less can edit all using the Nik 7 plugins. We'll start with the presets here too. The colors on this looks really good. We'll further make some adjustments to these to fine-tune the final look here. You can directly tune the intensity of the red, green and blue by just moving the sliders. Tuning the hues directly here is an easy way to get different looks too. You can get away just by single clicks for different categories with presets. We'll cover more in my future videos, so look forward to this. You can get 15% off of any software with this exclusive code or try it for free. No credit card required. More info in the video description. See you all in my next video. Thanks for watching.